this is question number 6, and remember students, this kind of sums will definitely come into the examination. We have to find the angle measure x in the given figure. So as it is a given quadrilateral, so let us give the name of this. Let us give the name ABCD. So you can see that three angles are given. The measure angle A is given 50, measure angle B is given 130, measure angle C is given 120, and the measure angle D is given x. So as it is a convex quadrilateral, we can say that three angles are given. The fourth we have to find out. Let us use the angle sum property of quadrilateral. So we know the angle sum property. The sum of all the angles of a quadrilateral is 360. So angle A plus angle B plus angle C plus angle D, that is equals to 360. Let us substitute the value of all the angles. A is 50, B is 130, C is 120, D is x, is 360. Let us do the sum of all this. It's like a linear equation in one variable, what we have already learned in the second chapter. I'll do the sum of all this. It's 200 and 300 plus x is equals to 360 degrees. I take this 300 right hand side, so 360 degrees minus 300 degrees, so we can obtain the value of x, that is 60 degrees. So we can say that the value of x in the given diagram is 60 degrees. Let us see this question. This question is better than the previous one. Again, it's a quadrilateral given. Let us give the name. It's ABCD. Now, if you observe carefully, the value of or the measure of angle A is given x. Angle B, that we don't have right now. See, angle C is 60 degrees. And angle D, which is given 70 degrees. Now, students, look at this. The angle, this measure given outside this. And this is called the internal angle, which is the angle B, which we require to find out x. X ढूंढने के लिए हमारे पास B, the interior angle should require. हमें बाहर का angle दिया. But if you observe this both the angles, so we can say they are forming a pair of linear equation. So we can say that the measure of angle B is equals to 180 minus 90 degree. See, why it is 90 degree? ये 90 कहाँ से आया? So as this sign is given, जब भी कोई angle ऐसा दिया होता है, so we should remember this is considered as right angle. Fine. So as it is given 90, but this is the exterior angle, and this both angles are forming linear pair. So we can say that the linear pair, one is given 90, so another can be obtained from 180 minus 90. So the interior angle B, that is also 90. Suppose ये 80 दिया होता, so this will come 100, and it's come 100. अगर ये 70 होता, this come 110. आगे ऐसे समझाएंगे. Now let us use the angle sum property. So angle A plus angle B plus angle C plus angle D is 360. Now angle A is x, B is 90, C is 60, and D is 70. This is 360. We'll do the sum of all these three. So it is 220. I take this to the right hand side. So value of x is equals to 360 minus 220. So the value of x we obtain 140 degrees. As we can say that angle is looked as an obtuse angle, and the measure is 140. Let us see this question. Students, remember, this is a very important question. Very important. Let me give this quadrilateral name. It's A. It's not a quadrilateral. B, C, D, and E. As it has a 5 sides, so it is a pentagon. It's not a regular pentagon. It's a pentagon. You can see that we have to use the angle sum property of a pentagon. But we don't have the two interior angles are given. Angle C and angle D, which are given, they are the exterior angle of angle C and exterior angle of angle D is given. So we need to find out what is the interior angle. So let's go for it. So let's find it out. So let's first find out the interior angle, angle C. So as we have done the previously, the interior of angle C can be obtained by supplementary angle. So supplementary, that means linear pair. 180 minus I'll do angle C. So it is 110 degree. This is angle C which we obtain. Let us obtain angle D. Again can be obtained 180 minus 60 degree. So that is 120. This is the angle D which we obtain. Now let's see that which angles are given. The value of angle A is given 30. Angle B is given X. Angle C we obtained 110. Angle D that is 120. And angle E that is obtained X. Now as it is a pentagon, so let us use the angle sum property. So angle A plus angle B plus angle C plus angle D plus angle E. Now recall the angle sum property. अभी हमने आगे एक सम किया था एंगल सम प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ सो द फॉर्मूला इज n माइनस 2 इंटू 180 इफ यू रिमेंबर सो लेट अस सब्स्टिट्यूट n इज 5 बिकॉज इट इज 5 साइड 5 इंटू 2 सो दैट इज 3 3 इंटू 180 सो वी कैन से दैट द एंगल सम प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ अ पेंटागॉन इज 540 दिस इज हाउ वी ऑब्टेन देयर इज नो नीड टू शो दिस इनटू द एग्जाम इट्स फाइन यू कैन राइट इट बाय यूजिंग एंगल सम प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ a pentagon. So 540. Now you can see the sum is like the same the previous number which we have done. We'll substitute all the value. This is 30 degree angle A. B is X. C is 110. Angle D is 120. This must be. And angle E is X. So it is 540. Now it form a linear equation. We have the two variables left hand side. So uska addition karenge, that is 2X. And we'll do the sum of this 30, 110 and 120. So addition will be 260. This is 540. Let's take this constant to the right hand side. So we will obtain 2x is equals to 540 minus 260. Let us do the subtraction of this. So it is 0, 8 and 208. So let us find out the value of x by taking 2 to the right hand side. So it comes in the denominator. So the value of x we obtain 140. So both the values of x are same and both values are 140. So remember students, it is a very very important question. Let's see this last question of question number 6. It's given a pentagon A, B, C, D, E. You can see that it's a regular pentagon. That means all the sides are equal as well as all angles are equal. So as it is a regular pentagon, so we can say that the value of each angle, angle A, angle B, angle C, angle D and angle E, all are same. Let us consider as X. Let's use the angle sum property of this. As we discussed earlier also, that angle sum property of a regular or any pentagon is 540 as we discussed in the previous question only. So all the values are x, x plus x, plus x, plus x and x. So we have 5 times x on the left hand side. So we will do 5x is equals to 540. I will take this value of x to the right hand side so it comes in the denominator. So when I do the cancellation, so 5 ones are not divisible, 5 ones are. So we can say that the value of each angle of this regular pentagon is 108 degree. Let us see this sum. This is the first question of question number 7. And we have to find out the value of x plus y plus z. Students, look at this value x, y and z. They are the angles, but you can see that they are the exterior angle. Let us give this vertex A, B and C. So, these are the exterior angle of angle A, exterior of angle B and exterior of angle C. So, we'll see that in the next exercise that the sum of exterior angle of any polygon is always 360. But as we cannot write here directly. So, let's see that how we'll find out x, y and z. So it is quite easy to do this. You can see that x and 90. So this x and 90, they are forming linear pair. So let's find out x by this way. X plus 90 is 180. As they are forming linear pair, we should consider as a linear pair. So I'll take x right hand, 180 minus 9, 90 right hand side. So the value of x we obtain is 90. So we will obtain x. The same way, z and 30, they are again forming linear pair. So z plus 30 is 180. So the value of z is equals to 180 minus 30. So the value of z we obtain is 150. So now we obtain x and z. Let us obtain y, but see the interior angle is not given. So let us first need to find out the interior angle of this triangle, then we'll go for the linear pair. Lamba method hai, but let's do this by the same way. Otherwise we'll obtain x plus y plus z as 360. We can write it direct also, but let's go by this way. By using angle sum property of a triangle, we are using the angle sum property of a triangle. So angle A, these are the interior angles. Whenever we say the interior angle, angle sum property. So angle A is 90, B we have to find out, and angle C is 30. So the sum of these two is 120. So I'll take that 120 to the right hand side. So 180 minus 120. 120 kahan se aaya, the sum of these two, and I have taken right hand side. So we will obtain angle B is equals to 60. As we obtain B, let us find out Y. So we can say that Y is equals to 180 minus angle B, that is 60 degree. So value of Y is 120 degree. As we obtain the value X, we obtain the value Y, and we obtain the value Z. So let us do that sum. X plus Y plus Z. X is 90, which we obtain. Y is 120. And this is 150. So now let us do the sum. 5 plus 2, 7. 7 plus 9. Raised to 1. So you can see that the sum of the exterior angle of this is 360. Let us see one more question of this question. Question number 7. That is the second one. Again, we have to find out sum of x, y, z and w, which are the exterior angles. So again, remember students, the sum of this exterior angle must be 360. But as we cannot write here, so let's first find out z, y and x as they are forming linear pair with the given angle. So let's do that. We can say 60 plus z is 180. So the value of z is equals to 180 minus 60. So you can see that the value of z is obtained 120 degree. The same way, y is forming linear pair with 80. So let us write down here directly, y is equals to 180 minus 80 degree. So this is 100 degree. So this we obtain the value of y. The same way, x is forming linear pair with 120 degree. So x is 180 minus 120 degree. So the value of x is obtained 60 degree. Now, the interior angle of W is not given, which is forming linear pair. So let us find out this angle B, the interior I am talking about, by using the angle sum property of a quadrilateral. Using angle sum property of a quadrilateral, angle sum property of a quadrilateral. So we can say that sum of all the angles of a quadrilateral is 360. Three angles which we have, angle A is 60, angle B we have to find out. These are the interior angles, 120, and angle D is 80, 360. So angle B, I'll do the sum of rest of this angle, so that is 260. I take this 260 to the right hand side, so angle B is equals to 360 minus 260. So the value of B, that is 100. Remember students, this angle is the interior angle. Ye angle mila hum, interior, 100 degree. Now we can obtain W by using the linear pair. So let us do the same way. W is equals to 180 minus the interior angle, that is 100. So the angle W we obtain, that is 80. Now according to the questions we have to find out x plus y plus z plus w. So let us go for it. Let's do the sum of all this. The value of x we have 60, y is 100, z is 120 and w is 80. So let us do the sum of all this. 8 plus 2, 10 plus 6, 16. So now you can see again this sum is 360. So again we'll come to the conclusion that sum of exterior angle of any polygon is always 360.